Let's look at properly interpreting a confidence interval for the population mean mu. The population mean mu is a parameter. It is a fixed value that is usually unknown, and we often wish to estimate mu with a confidence interval. Suppose we use this confidence interval formula to obtain a confidence interval for the parameter mu. This would be the appropriate method if we were sampling from a normally distributed population where the population standard deviation sigma is known. Properly interpreting the resulting interval is an important part of the analysis. Suppose we find a 95% confidence interval for the population mean of 4.8 to 22.7. What is a proper interpretation of this interval? Well, the short version is we can be 95% confident that the parameter mu lies within the interval. Note that the interpretation relates to the parameter mu and not the statistic x bar. The interpretation of a confidence interval always relates to a parameter and never a statistic. Although this is a reasonable interpretation, it is a touch unsatisfying. What precisely do we mean by 95% confident? Let's look at it from another perspective. Suppose we were to repeatedly sample from the population and calculate a 95% confidence interval for mu for each sample. Then 95% of these 95% confidence intervals would capture mu. Let's see what that looks like in a plot. Here I've drawn in a vertical line at the value of mu. Mu is a fixed value that is usually unknown to us, and so we are trying to estimate it with our confidence interval. And I could draw a random sample from the population and calculate a 95% confidence interval for mu, and it might look something like this. Here the large dot in the middle represents the value of the sample mean, and the dots on the ends are the endpoints of the interval. This particular interval captured the value of mu, or in other words, mu is contained within this 95% confidence interval. I could, if I so desired, draw another random sample from the population, get another value of the sample mean, and calculate another confidence interval, and it might look something like this. And this interval also captured the value of mu. And I could draw another sample, and another one, and on this fourth sample, we got an unusually small value of the sample mean x bar, and the resulting interval failed to capture mu. And I could repeatedly draw samples from the population and calculate a 95% confidence interval for mu for each sample, and it might look something like this. And some of these intervals are going to capture mu, and some of them are going to miss. And the underlying mathematical theory tells us that 95% of the intervals calculated in this manner will capture mu, and 5% of the intervals will miss. In practice, we are only going to draw one sample, and thus we're only going to have a single confidence interval for mu, and we're not going to know with certainty whether our interval was one of those that captured mu, or our interval was one of those that missed. But we can be 95% confident that our interval was one of those that captured mu. Let's look at a practical example. Body mass index, which is a person's weight in kilograms divided by their height in meters squared, is a measure of body shape. A random sample of 28 female students at a university had a sample mean body mass index of 24.7. And suppose the corresponding 95% confidence interval for mu is found to be 22.6 to 26.8. What is a proper interpretation of this interval? Well, the short version is we can be 95% confident that the population mean mu lies within this interval. But what does that mean in the context of this problem? A simple interpretation of this interval is that we can be 95% confident that the mean body mass index of all female students at this university lies between 22.6 and 26.8. We could also say that in repeated sampling, 95% of the 95% confidence intervals calculated in this manner would capture the true mean body mass index of female students at this university. And since we have one of those intervals, we can be 95% confident that our interval captures mu. Let's look at a couple of misconceptions that people sometimes have. These are most definitely incorrect interpretations of a confidence interval. This first one is wrong because we are not saying anything about the percentage of students with a body mass index that falls between those two values. We are simply saying something about the population mean value. This second statement is wrong because it is discussing the value of the sample mean body mass index, and we have constructed a confidence interval for the population mean body mass index. And so our interpretation of the confidence interval must relate to the population mean. A proper interpretation of a confidence interval always relates to the value of a parameter, and not the value of a statistic.